This movie demonstrates the Heller myotomy being performed for achalasia. We begin the procedure by opening up the peritoneum overlying the angle of His, and the dissection continues overlying the loose phrenoesophageal ligament until we're able to visualize the posterior mediastinum. Dissection continues in the posterior mediastinum in order to be able to have at least 6 centimeters along the esophagus. And now we open up the gastrohepatic ligament to visualize the right crura. If any bleeding is encountered, it's generally advisable to utilize a piece of gauze to control that bleeding and to minimize the use of cautery and the subsequent risk of burn injury. Please note that dissection is taking place to expose the anterior surface of the esophagus, as it's not customarily required to perform a complete circumferential dissection of the esophagus when performing the Heller myotomy. At this point, the ruler is passed into the posterior mediastinum, with the goal being to have a dissection of at least 6 centimeters from the GE junction. By utilizing the three arms of the robot, one can provide the traction and counter-traction that is classically required for surgical performance, and the use of the robotic instrumentation allows for excellent maneuverability. Once the plane is created between the circular muscle layer and the underlying mucosa, one can then utilize the robotic instrumentation almost like a finger to gently dissect and create a plane. This dissection will continue along the esophagus into the posterior mediastinum in order to get at least 6 centimeters of myotomy along the esophagus. Once again, the vagus nerve is visualized and preserved. At this point, we proceed our dissection along the gastric muscular component, and one can visualize that the gastric mucosa has a slightly darker red color compared to the esophageal mucosa, which is more of a white color. It is convenient utilizing the robot, as one has excellent maneuverability, just like you would if you were doing open surgery with your hand. Any small amount of bleeding that's encountered along the mucosa is best handled by application of the gauze instead of using cautery and risking burning the mucosa with a subsequent perforation a few days later. Pulling on the cut edges of the myotomy allows one to visualize if there are any further muscle fibers that are left to be taken down. At this point, the assistant passes down the endoscope, and the goal is to be able to visualize the light from the endoscope, confirming that dissection was adequate and got down to the mucosa. Demonstration of the vagus nerve, which is preserved and left intact. A dual fund application is then performed at conclusion, with multiple bites taken of the gastric aspect and incorporating the cut edge of the myotomy. Please note great care is taken not to accidentally apophate through the mucosa at this stage. The instrument that's utilized allows you to both cut and to manipulate the needle. After performing multiple such sutures on the left side, we will then proceed to perform the same type of sutures on the right side in order to essentially cover up the exposed mucosa. The bites on the right side also incorporate a portion of the right crura in order to minimize the chance of this as portion of the esophagus migrating into the posterior mediastinum. And the stomach is fixed circumferentially along the area of the hiatus to completely close off the area of the hiatus. This is a completed view. Thank you for your attention.